welcome to a brand new season of Fresh. It's NRL Fever and you're kicking it with the freshest of the fresh.
Keep it fresh.
Woo! Coming up fresh for you today.
What do I wear with the E inside? When I'm at home, just nothing. Nothing at all, just the E.
Some island food flavours for your Saturday morning.
All right, here goes, guys.
Wait. Wrong already.
Welcome back, Auntie Tala, in a brand new but always crack up Faika Colour with Tala.
So how you been?
Oh, you know.
That's good.
Same old.
Right now, we're getting down with the Brown at the NRL camp.
We're about to find out who's got the best moves on and off the field.
Keep it fresh!
So we're running the NRL Pacific Leadership Camp, which is basically a leadership camp for our Pacific players. We bring in two or three players from each club who've been identified by their clubs as guys with leadership potential, and we want to help challenge them and upskill them to be able to take a bit more responsibility, to be able to help our people a bit more.
Fantastic, thank you very much.
I think these sort of camps are very important because it gives the boys an opportunity to understand that you're not just an athlete, you actually have an influence on a bigger community. And the way you carry yourself as an athlete, the way you develop as an athlete, eventually transcends into the community. Every time we get together, the boys go, why don't we do this more often? The guys always ask you, are we having an island feed? You know, we're going to get the chop suey and the oka. You know, I'm not coming in unless we're doing that, you know.
I laugh when I hear Australian commentators try and say the Islander boys' names. It's funny as.
They used to call me my uncle's name, Danny Lima.
Saifidi.
Matt Owiti was probably the weirdest one that I've got.
Tunawaipea, that's the most common one.
They call Raja Master Chef instead of Tuvasa Sheik, because it's just easier to pronounce, I guess.
Siwa Taukiaho. They normally say Taukilaho.
Used to, you know, getting our names called wrong the whole time, so when the commentators say it, doesn't really bug me. But if they come up to me, I do correct them. That girl is a real crowd, please.
So the NRL does a lot of community projects, you know, talk to the schools and all that sort of stuff. Our boys are really passionate, obviously, about giving back to our own people, so we throw this on top and give them an opportunity not just to help everyone, but then also help our own people as well on our own specific issues that are close to our heart.
This camp's been amazing. It's definitely empowered me to be a leader.
I think the biggest thing is for us Pacific Islanders to have a voice.
We're in a position of power, which we're fortunate, so these little problems that we're learning, we get that information and we're lucky enough to project that and people listen to us.
You know, I want to try and help in my part in any way possible, and, you know, so eating right and promoting eating good on social media would probably, you know, set a good standard.
A young guy coming in, it's good to know all this stuff and just to be able to learn from the older boys about how much it means to them.
We control 40% of the playing popularity in the NRL, so, you know, we definitely need to go back to our roots, that's for sure.
It's definitely important for me to represent Fiji. That's where my mum's from, she's from Fiji, and I'm a mama's boy, so yeah, I'm proud to be a Fijian as well as an Australian.
Get done with it.
This is a new segment called Threads,
where we check out who's got the freshest fittings
and to see if this guy can tie his ear lover lover properly.
Don't be sad, Osper. My parents are watching me.
Oh, sorry, Russ.
Silent.
In Tonga, we call it tupenu. It's kind of similar to this, but we usually kind of wear to church. It's one of our culture uniform that we used to wear. Like, people go to church or we go visit the kings or even going to our grandparents' house and stuff. We used to wear the tupenu as one of our culture clothes, and just to show respect. Every time I wear it, yeah, I feel like I'm back home, and yeah, just give me memories when I grew up as a kid. And my brothers and them, we kind of like wear the same one, and whoever's got the cleanest one will fight for it. And I was the youngest and I always lose, So yeah, I always have to wear the old one. The Tongan tupenu, you got like something to tie on the side, both sides at the end, but when I wear the Samoan or the ear one, I just show you a little demo. I just grab the side and just in, just tie a knot. Where's the, here we go. Just tie it together and then like that. Yeah. What do I wear with the ear inside? When I'm at home, just nothing at all, just the ear. But if I go somewhere, obviously I get to wear something inside just before the, because the wind get like easily blown out. It goes like everywhere. So I guess it's better to cover it up, but it comes handy sometimes. Gold is always hot, so at home I just put on the ear and it just, every time I put it on, I just finger firm and yeah, I feel good about myself, so yeah.
Make sure you guys come back after the break
to check out one of the biggest afros in the NRL.
Maybe even the world.
He's just jealous, man, isn't he?
It's like a tumbleweed.
Sweet, see you then. It's good to learn off him, and I always ask him about diet because he's got the 17 pack, I only got the 1 pack.
My son's going out with a real ugly kid. I saw a photo, yeah. And I was like, what sort of filter is that? He said, there's no filter. I was like, ooh.
Hey, what day is it today, bro?
Today is the first day. I'm going to start my no-liquid diet.
Ha ha, then you must be thirsty, yeah?
Oh yeah, especially on my first day.
Well, you better be careful, because you might need some first aid.
My name's Aloni Vinikede. By day, I work as a garbage collector, just your average blue-collar, high-vis wearing worker. But by night, fortunately enough, I get to rub shoulders with some of the biggest names in the sporting world. Welcome to my world.
I was born in Paddington, just around the corner down the road from where we are here in Kensington. A lot of people think I was born in Fiji, but no, I was born and raised in Sydney. Typical islander, I guess, one of seven from my father. I'm the eldest of three with my mum and my dad. So there's a big span of about 30 years when my dad was highly active in fertility, so yeah. Football was something that I excelled in. Athletically, I was a bit more developed compared to a lot of the other, I guess, Aussie kids that I was hanging around with, so I could sort of assert my size and athletic attributes. Took it out of the Palangis a bit, and I don't think they liked it too much because I was always a bony, hard kid. I spent 6 years in reserve grade. I think I earned a total of about $22,000 for 6 years of work, which doesn't even pay for your fuel to drive from work to training. But that didn't deter me. It wasn't ever about money. Money was always just a bonus to me. Opportunity-wise, I didn't know what was coming, so I took on a job as a waste service collection is the formal title, but Garbo is known over here in Australia. Within a month of getting that job, I got given the opportunity to train part-time with the Roosters. So Thursday came around, my training day. I asked Robbo if I could come in and do more than I was currently allocated. Yeah, from that day forward, I started training full-time with the Roosters and juggled the two.
He's real hard-working, you know, he's real passionate about the sport. After a massive training session, he always chuck on his high vest and be like, Tolly, where are you going? He's like, oh, I got work now. It's good to learn off him, and I always ask him about diet because he's got the 17 pack, I only got the 1 pack, so hopefully it'll come soon.
Image-wise, I always looked up to big, strong, masculine guys as heroes. My first ever, I guess, real test match for Fiji was when I was 26, and yeah, got to run out alongside Petra and Simi Ranjanja, just guns of our modern sort of NRL Fijian era.
Try for Eloni Vunakase. That's how you execute.
I think everyone enjoys having Fijians around, so I guess we contribute in that sense. We're a pretty sort of happy-go-lucky kind of people. You don't want to get on our wrong side because we can hurt you. So the hair in school, the boys said to me they knew. But I hadn't shaved my head for a while. The boys would see my hair starting to curl and jam pencils in there and stuff. And they said to me one day, Lonnie, why don't you grow your hair? And I said, yep, I'm going
to
do it.
I reckon Lonnie tried to copy Willie Mason. Or even Crit. You know Crit? Y'all guys know Crit? Yeah, I reckon he tried to copy Crit. But yeah, it looks like a big ball of tumbleweed. It's been rolling through the desert and then just sat up on his head. And then, like a bird's nest.
The colour comes from the sun. People think I dye it, but I don't. I often get asked, is it a wig? No, I don't wear a wig out. It's just my hair.
5 feet, you got to remind yourself how young he is. Funakete crashes over.
There's so many, I guess, opportunities for us to be leaders in our community. Without really even knowing it, we can sort of be an inspiration and inspire change and inspire someone to be something bigger than what they think they are. A lot of the things that I do is all for the family. Yeah, it's just providing for my kids. Every cent that I make now is solely for my kids. It's just to provide for them, for their lives, and try to make their lives as good as possibly can be.
We all know Islanders like their food, right?
Yeah, but we need to stop eating that corned beef, you know, and the burgers. And eat some real island food like this. You know, raw fish, tarot, real big like it.
Hey, right? Yeah. The banana there too, the raw fish.
Good protein, you know?
That's it.
Build it up, get ready.
Kia rana freshies, my name is Amy K. Nuku and I'm coming to you from Rarotonga. I'm taking this mature coconut, also known as an uto, to my friend Rangi, and she's going to teach me how to make pancakes with it.
When it falls from the tree and it lands on the ground and sits there, if it's not taken away by someone, the roots start to form and then the shoot starts to come out again. There's a sort of marshmallowy inside. We use that, we get it out.
How do we open it?
Okay, we're going to have to husk the coconut first.
Right.
We're going to cut it open. Get the uto out, and then we'll grate it. And it was cut lengthwise, not across, which is usually the case. Lengthwise so that it's easy to get the uto out of the coconut.
All right, here goes, guys.
Wait.
Wrong already.
See? Yeah. That yep. Mouth.
Only allowed to learn it
only
once.
Only learn it once. That's it.
Well,
well done! Wow. Okay, now try and loosen it out. People in Rarotonga don't usually utilise uto in their food. It's really a northern group dish. So that's why my friend's getting all excited about it, because she's finally done it. Okay, let's move to the kitchen. And you're just going to grate. You don't want to go too far into that top part. The ingredients that go into making the uto pancake, which is really like a fritter, is the uto, is flour and sugar, and it's cooked in the vegetable oil. There is a ratio of grated uto to flour, and the measurement is 2 to 1.
Why is it an important ingredient?
It costs nothing. It just grows naturally, and there's plenty of it, especially in the Pacific Islands. So we need to learn how to utilize ingredients that are there waiting for us. The other reason is that it's good for you. And this is pretty much incorporated. I just squeeze it a little bit. I'm releasing some of the liquid that's inside the uto, which binds this whole thing. That's the consistency that we need.
Oh my gosh. Chewy, crunchy, sweet. So there we have it, freshies. Uto pancakes, absolutely delicious. They're really freaking beautiful.
Make sure you come back after the break. Auntie Talon's back trying to take down Pani in the ultimate Super Shade Showdown. See you then.
I thought she was gonna be one of those cheeky girls.
Oh, look at mom. Sorry, carry on.
Pardon?
Hey, what did I tell you about all this rubbish around over here? Come and clean it up.
I'll clean it later.
Oh, not the 3-litre bakes.
Nah, just a 3-litre milk.
Meal time!
What is it?
It's a litter from Santa.
Welcome back to Fresh Guys. It's NRL week and you're hanging with us.
Now it's time for some favourite Auntie Fekakala.
Yeah!
You got enough room there, Sabrina?
Only just. How are you, Tala?
Yeah, I'm good. I haven't seen you in church in quite a while.
Yeah, because you haven't been here in quite a while.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
So how have you been?
Oh, you know.
That's good.
Same old. And how have you been? Yeah. Awesome.
Oh,
great.
It's like that, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, straight to the point.
Did you eat something you're allergic to?
Yes. Fresh air. Blocked by here.
Swelling up all over the place. How was your week this week?
Oh, you know, same old, helping my daughter get through med school.
Oh, your daughter?
Yeah. I thought she was going to be one of those cheeky girls, you know.
Oh, like a mom. Sorry, carry on.
Pardon?
No, I mean, I got the mumps.
Oh, I thought so.
Yeah. She's at med school.
Yeah.
Oh, why is she going there?
Because she really wants to be a doctor.
Wow. You need to tell her the truth. There's no way she's going to be a good doctor. Eh?
You're right. I tried to tell her, but then she got scholarships, and now she's in her third year.
Definitely her father's side.
What about your son?
Oh, he's doing really well.
I heard he's doing lots of things and lots of folks.
Sorry? talking about your son.
Oh, no. So what's he doing now?
Oh, he's actually at law school.
Oh.
He's studying there. He's got his BCA, BDW, NCA, NWA, and BMW.
Wow.
And WWE. He's got all those degrees.
That's amazing.
His business card's going to be too long because too many letters, more letters than the numbers.
Wow.
Yeah. You might need a lawyer for whoever does your makeup.
Well, at least I shaved my beard before I came to church.
Oh, so you do shave?
Yeah, I do.
I don't shave.
I can tell.
I'm natural. It's good your daughter's going to be a doctor.
That's good that your son's going to be a loser.
She needs something to be attractive because her looks is not going to help.
Do you know what's so funny? My daughter told me that she's seeing a guy.
Is that right?
And she said, Mommy, please, I don't want you to judge him. I don't want you to meet him because he's really makwa'ole young, man.
Is that right?
And I said, it's not about the outside, it's about the inside. And she showed me like a part of the face, and it really is about the outside. Oh, come on, hold down.
Really ugly.
She said, yeah, it looks exactly like his mother.
My son's going out with a real ugly girl. I saw a photo, and I was like, what sort of filter is that? He said, there's no filter. I was like,
Oh, no.
Yeah. It's like a car ran over his face 7 times.
Well, I wish a car did run over his face 7 times.
Well, he told me that she had a tattoo of a telescope on her shoulder because she's at medical school. You know those things they put on their ears to listen to their music?
You mean a stethoscope?
Oh, they're using those now.
Yeah. And does your son have a birthmark on his back? My daughter said that her boyfriend's got a big birthmark on his back that looks like Savai and Upolu joined together.
Okay. Lucky we come to church.
Yeah.
Pray about this thing.
That's right.
Pray. That it's not true that
I hope it's not
your daughter stayed in my
Oh my gosh, son. I can't believe she's going to be your son.
Kia ora, this is my poly postcard from New York.
Keeping it fresh in Manhattan.
Tips on how to do New York in 5 days.
Number one, my first tip I suggest is to buy the New York Pass. It costs over $100, but it gives you free entry or discounted entry to over 80 attractions, which would normally cost you hundreds and hundreds of dollars more. Number two, take one of the many bus tours in the first few days. That'll help you get your bearings and how far away everything is. Number three, be prepared to enjoy the surroundings and people while you wait in queues. And definitely suggest to get to some of the attractions nice and early before they open. Number four, bring good shoes because you can walk most places beating the lights and traffic. And number five, make a clear list of the important things for you to go see. You can still relax and enjoy your time in a short 5 days.
We're keeping it fresh to death from Harlem to New Zealand.
Keeping it fresh here in Brooklyn.
That's me, keeping it fresh here in the Big Apple, New York City.
I'm a dangerous man with some money in my pocket.
Keep up!
Well, we hope you enjoyed today's show. It's been awesome having news. Make sure you come back next week to see this guy.
Jose Parker!
Talo for Love Fresh fans, next week on Fresh, you're chilling with me in Las Vegas. 24 karat magic in the
air.
Until then, keep it fresh! Woo.